football games. We want to get to the bowl games. We want to win the Pac-10. I mean, let's don't settle with little things. You know, let's start here, continue to work, and try to get to the top, because that's what the athletes come here for, and that's why I came here. I want to be the best that we can be at Oregon State, and that's what it's all about.
Just got better and better as the year went on. they learn how to mesh together. They learn how to mesh better with Coach Smith and his philosophy on how things need to be done. And it was great. You know, it was rare moments where they actually had any arguments. You know, for the most part, they really just got together. And when they would bump heads, it became humorous because you knew they knew each other. They were just that comfortable working with each other.
One-year transfer Imani Percoats gave way to another first-year senior in Chad Johnson, a big play target destined to grace the cover of Sports Illustrated. Robert Prescott, Martin Maurer, and T.J. Hushmanzada would team with Johnson to provide Jonathan Smith an inevitable open man.
You know, if you're going to set up your game plan, you're going to try and stop Ken Simonton. You're going to try and stop Chad Johnson, T.J., you know, and maybe control Prescott. You know, and you almost forget about the tight end sometimes, you know, because those were the guys that, you know, were breaking everybody's back down the stretch. You know, so they'd set their game plan up that way, you know, and it opens some stuff up. You know, anytime you get a linebacker covering myself, I smile, you know, when it's one-on-one without any help from a safety, you know, because I expect to win.
Smith continues to prove that instinct, guile, and heart can overcome any shortcomings. The junior signal caller, initially mistaken by his head coach as a team manager, would no doubt establish himself as OSU's winningest quarterback ever.
Well, when I come here, I wanted to get away from home. I wanted to have a four-year experience at a college. I didn't want to go to junior college. I wanted to be a part of a team. I wanted to learn football. And so, you asked me my dreams. My realizations were more or less I wanted to compete for a starting spot, maybe my junior or senior year. And so the way things have worked out, it's definitely been a dream come true.
Behind him, Ken Simonton led a triumvirate and unquestionably the Pac-10's best backfield. Erickson's scheme features a single back, and you'd think it wouldn't provide enough action for such talent. Not so. The heralded Simonton, Michigan transfer Patrick McCall, and senior Antonio Battle handle the duties with the aplomb of blood brothers, rushing for more than 2,400 yards and 27 touchdowns.
You know, we all just came together and worked with each other real well and just came together as one, which helped us out, you know, in the long run as far as winning and having a great season.
The lifeblood of the 2000 Beavers was a dominant defense, the Pac-10's best.
Defense won 11 games for us, there's no question about it. Anytime you're really good on defense, you get a chance to win. And there were so many games as you look through the season that that we played great on defense and ended up winning the game because of it. Our offense caught up with them towards the middle of the season, and then we were really hitting on all cylinders. But our defensive football team was probably as good as anybody in the country.
Bookends, DeLawrence Grant and Ladarius Jackson wreaked havoc on opposing backfields. Zepha O'Reilly and Kyle Rozelle backed them up with big plays. There was no respite up the middle as tackles Eric Manning, Ryan Atkinson, and Dwan Edwards got into the act.
We make breaks before the game as we do our individuals, though, and we come together as a defensive line. And our break is D-line family.
The linebacking corps had the depth to handle some of the infrequent injuries that hit the Beavers. Tavita Moala had been penciled in as the starter in the middle, but he shared that duty with an All-American freshman in redshirt, Richard Siegler. Nick Barnett admirably spelled James Allen until an acupuncturist had the latter playing as well as anyone at his position in the Pac-10. Darnell Robinson played true to form on the strong side, creating big plays, leading the team in tackles, and joining Grant and Terrence Carroll as defensive captains.
Bill's engine never started running. His mouth never started running. So it was like, you know, defense is always fired up, and defense always came to play this year. And just the linebackers, I think, sparked all that.
The secondary returned intact from the year previous.
We had a lot of returners in the secondary with Terrence Carroll and Calvin Carlisle, and then Dennis Weathersby at corner, and Keith Hayward Johnson, and Ricky Walker, and the emergence of Jay Cookus. We had a lot of depth, and the secondary, without a doubt, was a strength for us.
Many starters and other key players fulfill vital roles on a solid special team effort. Mike Fessler came through with clutch punting, pinning opponents inside the 20 or booming them out from just outside his own end zone. Place kicker Ryan Seska earned a pair of Pac-10 Special Team Player of the Week honors for his effort in the mid to late season games.
after the Washington game, I was 1-for-2. No one knew what was going to happen. Basically, just worked hard, worked on everything. Worked, you know, every single practice just to get better, and it paid off.
August camp was a harbinger of mid-season play to come. The defense had the better of the competition and grew all that much closer, celebrating each other's heroics in lieu of going 20-plus days without an opponent in their sights. The offense started to get its bearings in the latter weeks of preseason workouts, and by Labor Day weekend, most everything appeared in place. It was time, and the Big Sky's Eastern Washington Eagles were to provide opening fodder for an anxious OSU squad. Instead, like a car sputtering to ignition after lengthy hibernation, the Beavers struggled to maintain control and left nearly all involved wondering if they had misplaced expectations. Simonton picked up where he left off with 200 yards on 40 carries and 3 scores. But surely, after this one, they had no idea how this season's script would end. Game one.
Under center, Chris Polander. Quick drop back on the reverse. The ball is loose. Picked up by DeLawrence Grant at the 20. Down he goes at the Eagle 19. Kenny the handoff. He's the all-time leading rusher. And Moore inside the 10. Down to about the 5-yard line of Eastern Washington. And with that carry, in 2 years and one game plus, Ken Simonton has become the all-time leading rusher at Oregon State University. Jonathan Smith to throw. Over the middle. Caught by Maurer at the 40. To the 45. Up to midfield where he's gang tackled. Ball on the 10-yard line from the left hash after the penalty. Give it off to Javon Griffith, and Griffith hit at the line of scrimmage and fumbled the football, and the Beavers have recovered. And it's exactly what Bob Krim was talking about during the break. Bob, you said to keep this thing going, if the D could make a big play right away, they could really take control of this football game. The ball from the right hash, and Simonton running left, now kicks it outside, turns the corner to Dan. Great fake at the 5, and Simonton into the end zone. Touchdown, Beavers! Kenny Simonton again. 2nd and 7, Simonton right tackle. Kenny turns it outside, breaks a tackle at the 5, and Simonton dances into the end zone again. Touchdown, Beavers!
That OSU engine was about to kick over and into gear in game 2. But still didn't take full measure of what was under the hood. Simonton ran for another 184 yards, and McCall started to ease the burden on Ken. Though the defense kept their collective thumbs squarely weighted on the New Mexico ground game, the Beavers didn't put more on the board than the Lobos until the final quarter, game 2.
On 3rd and a long 2, it's McCall started up the middle, cuts it back, and breaks free. He's at the 30. McCall at the 15-yard line. Down to the 10, inside the 5, and down he goes at the New Mexico 2-yard line. 41 yards for Patrick McCall, showing some great cutback ability. Murdoch taking a long look. His snap is on target to Fessler, who's trying to pin this one inside the 5. The Beavers hustling down. It takes a good Beaver bounce, and Jake Cookus gets down and downs it at the 2-yard line. Fessler, I thought, had a little too much leg into it. Come on, a play action fake. Throwback screen intercepted by Ladarius Jackson. Jackson on his way to the house. Touchdown, Beavers! Ladarius Jackson! Ryden McCall still in there. Smith to throw. The out. Caught by TJ. Turns it up at the 5 to the 2. Touchdown, Beavers! TJ Hushmanzada. And we're even at 20 with 11:37 to play in the fourth quarter. Coming under Chris Gibson, the 25-second clock down to 5. The game clock to 120. Smith to Simonton. Kenny first down and breaks free. 25-20. Kenny inside the 10 to the 5. Touchdown, Beavers! Ken Simonton!
Well, if you've got a good running back, I guess you give him the football. You know, we talked about it a moment ago. I said, well, what do you do? Well, obviously, you run it. If it's 4th and inches, the game is on the line. And what a gamer. Ken Simonton right off the left side, and it was a foot race to the end zone.
The first back out of the eye. Rolling right is Kamano under pressure. Sandwich throws, and it's picked off by Keith Hayward Johnson. Keith Hayward, who just had the great coverage, makes the interception at his own 28-yard line. The Beavers get the pick and should win the football game.
San Diego State was the last of the non-conference tune-ups and OSU needed a full spark prior to Pac-10 play. A balanced charge included 172 yards to numerous receivers and another 164 on the ground. The defense continued its assault with 17 tackles for loss, 5 sacks, and forcing 7 turnovers. Now this was what the Beaver fans were looking for. Game 3.
Pass on first down, Larry Ned hit in the backfield, and this time the Beavers won't lose him. DeLawrence Grant finishes the job that Eric Manning started, and it'll be a loss for Ned of a couple of yards to his 43-yard line, setting up second down and 12. Sean Pierce flanked to the right, and with the pressure on and the blitz, Darnell Robinson breaks through and sacks Lon Sheriff back at the 37-yard line. Darnell Robinson with the sack on the blitz coming from his outside linebacker spot. Aaron Hill flanked right, the blitz is on. Smith, a pump and go, and he's got a man open, and it's caught by Chad Johnson! Touchdown, Beavers! Say hello to number 80, Chad Johnson on the touchdown. Back to throw goes Sheriff with a blitz on, and Ziegler has him for a sack back at the 3-yard line. On third and 20, they run that, who fumbles the football. The ball is loose. The Beavers recover. Touchdown, Beavers! Look at the Sim Janowski, a pretty good move. T.J. Hushman's out of back, pedals to his 33. Sidesteps a man and comes up the middle of the 40. He's at the 45 to midfield. He has one man to beat. He's at the 30. TJ with a chance, but he's dragged down from behind at the 20-yard line. TJ Hushmanzada.
Next, one of the last monkeys on the back of the OSU rise from a forgettable past, the USC Trojans. Two 3-0 teams met in the conference opener before a national TV audience and a sold-out Reese Stadium. Though 8th-ranked Troy came in with great expectations, little did they know that a 33-year streak would end this very day. Simonton rumbled for a career-high 234 rushing yards, and the defense held the Trojans to a quarter of that total. And lest we forget, the momentum-turning goal-line-to-goal-line scamper by the fans' favorite marsupial. Game 4.
Shotgun sets up, throws. He's got Johnson, makes the catch at the 5, into the end zone. Touchdown, Beavers! Chad Johnson for the touchdown, and the Beavers lead it 6-0 with 9:28 to play. Papadakis in there, and he gets the handoff, and he's hit and tackled for a loss back to the 27-yard line. Nick Barnett tackling Papadakis for a loss of 2 on 3rd and 1. With the slot right, Simonton up the middle. Simonton into the secondary, spins, breaks the tackle to the 10, to the 5! Touchdown, Beavers! Ken Simonton! The 35, Palmer play action fake. Atkinson coming from the backside. Atkinson, Darnell Robinson pulls him down for a sack back at the 40-yard line of Oregon State. Back two wideouts, Carson Palmer gives it off to the deep man, and Ladarius Jackson tackles McKenzie for a loss. They'll spot the football at the 8-yard line. That's a loss of 4 on the play. Will field it at his 6, come up the right sideline, gets out to the 20, and blasted there! What a huge hit for the Beavers on special teams, and it looked like Eric Tuma got down to unload on our bet. Slot left, Palmer on a bootleg, rolling right under pressure, throws, intercepted by Terrence Carroll! Carroll on the run at the 30, Terrence with a chance to go! Carson Palmer chasing him, 35, 30, 25, down goes Carroll at the SC 18-yard line! Simon to the handoff, can't, cuts to the left, first down and more, 30, 25, 20, Simonton on his way, can, into the end zone, touchdown Beavers, and the streak is going to end here tonight. Smith takes the snap, takes a knee, and the ball game's going to come to an end. The clock will count down, but the celebration has begun again at Research Stadium.
It was a wake-up call, if you will, the lone lurch of a gear shift before gaining speed. Washington found a temporary counter to the Beavers' defensive team speed. Screens and draws caught OSU off guard, and future opponents would look to follow the Husky lead without success. Once burned, and once only. Smith had another magical game at Husky Stadium, tossing for 314 of the Beavers' 474 total yards, and the final drive needed another minute, or 2 yards to the left on a game-tying kick to end the thriller. Game five.
He just beat the 25 count, back to throw, and DeLawrence Grant has him, and sacks him, back at the 37-yard line. A loss of about 8 as D. Grant would not be denied. Short 2 for the first down from the 28 in Washington territory. Option to Iasisopo, keeps and hits, and is tackled for a loss at the 27-yard line. The Husky 48 play action, boot, rolling across his body to the left, throwing deep to a wide open Prescott at the 15, to the 10, to the 5, and he's in! Touchdown Beavers, Robert Prescott! Patrick bounces it outside, he's at the 40, the 35, to the 30, down the left sideline to the 15, to the 10, to the 5, and McColl is in! Touchdown Beavers, Patrick McColl! The naked backfield from the 34, here comes Sepha O'Reilly and gets him back at the 36-yard line. Sepha O'Reilly coming off the edge for the sack. It'll be second down. Takes the snap, goes back to throw, steps up, fires in the end zone, caught! Touchdown Beavers! T.J. Hushmanzada! Jonathan Smith throws both hands high into the air to the heavens and salutes the Oregon State crowd. Tui Asasopo fumbles the ball, picked up by the Beavers! Keith Hayward Johnson is going to go all the way, I believe it's Keith. On his way, it is Keith Hayward Johnson running free for 2 points. The first ever for the Beavers. They get 2 as Keith Hayward Johnson goes about 98 yards. Back to throw goes Smith. Half roll, stumbles, throws deep. He has Chad Johnson, fakes the catch. Chad at the 25 to the 20. Johnson's going to go in. Touchdown Beavers on a great play by Jonathan Smith. And a touchdown for Chad Johnson. 80 yards from Smith to Johnson with 7:22 to play. Michael, go ahead.
That's a great pass by Jonathan Smith. He lost his shoe as he planted to make that pass. That was a one-foot pass by Jonathan Smith that goes 80.
The current win streak started at home in front of a Dad's Weekend crowd in mid-October. 7 days after the backfire in Seattle, the engine was running on all cylinders and would run at that clip into the new year. Pac-10 defending champ Stanford was OSU's first speed bump, but the Beavers didn't slow for it at all. For the second straight year, Bill Cosby set the tone.
Stanford!
Game six.
Slot to the left side. TJ inside of Johnson. Off of play action. Rolling left is Jonathan. Has nothing to do with it. Now throws back across the field. Hushmanzada makes the catch and runs down the right sideline. TJ's going to go all the way. Touchdown Beavers. Jonathan to TJ Hushmanzada. Looking for his career high 49-yarder. Out of the hole to Fessler. The kick from 49 yards is good. And the ball not only was right on target, it knocked over a photographer down below. He left hash, play action fake. Lewis with plenty of time steps up, rifles it downfield. Intercepted by Terrence Carroll. Carroll turns it back upfield to the 25, to the 30, out to the 39-yard line. Terrence Carroll on the interception. And for TC, who's finishing his career in marvelous style, gets his fourth interception of the year. Pressure coming, flushed out of the pocket, sprinting for his life to the right, and tripped up from behind.
chase in this script was appropriately reserved for a stone's throw from Hollywood. 604 yards of total offense included 100-yard gains by Symington and McCall, while their backup, Antonio Battle, rambled the most important 23 yards. Three OSU receivers also passed the century mark in an exhausting night in the Rose Bowl. Game 7.
Third down, a long three for the Beavers from the UCLA 8. Three-step drop, Smith throws for Chad Johnson on the slant. Touchdown, Beavers! Chad Johnson running a great pattern, and Jonathan Smith with a perfect strike. Corey Paz straight back to throw, sets up under pressure, and Ladarius Jackson sacks him back at the 8-yard line. They fake the draw on a shotgun. Smith throws to Marty Maurer. Maurer fumbles it into the hands of Prescott, and Robert gets to the outside. Prescott's going to go in. Touchdown, Beavers. Robert Prescott on the volleyball from Marty Maurer. One wide receiver to the right, over the middle, on the crossing route, T.J. Hushmanzada makes the catch and goes in. Touchdown, Beavers. Forget about three. The Beavers get six on the 13-yard slant inside to T.J. Hushmanzada. Ryan Poley-Dixon on first down, toss sweep. Akeel Harris into the backfield, and the ball comes loose. The Beavers say they've got it. We'll see. The ball is loose at the 20. Michael, what do you got?
Oregon State.
It is Beaver football.
Simon, and he's
Wade is on his way into the end zone. Touchdown, Beavers. Chris Martin had to hold Chad Johnson earlier, and this time couldn't hold on to Hushman Zada, who caught it on the hitch, and as he does so well, Bob, does a great job after the catch. He broke away from Martin in that single coverage situation and takes it in for a 26-yard touchdown. Matt Kegel comes under center and goes back to throw on third and long, trying to set up a screen. Now he fumbles the football, plays it off the turf, and goes down to Lawrence Grant, tackling Kegel back at the 34-yard line. They're going to have to punt it on fourth and forever.
The good teams survived their scares during the long fall campaign, a fitting description for OSU's invasion of Strawberry Canyon. The Beavers held a 31-12 advantage just before the half, but had to stave off a Cal rally to win. McCall and Simonton split 235 rushing yards, but again, an unlikely rusher had perhaps the most crucial yards of the day. Game 9.
This Hushman's out of from left to right. Simonton runs left. Kent to the 40, down the left sideline of midfield. Has a chance. He's at the 35 to the 30, 25 to the 20. He's hit at the 10 and dragged down inside at about the 3-yard line. As Bowler goes back to throw. Pressure coming and down he goes and a sack. Back at the Cal 46-yard line, and it's Ladarius Jackson making the play. The Beavers blitz and throwing deep off of play action is Bowler, and going up is Keith Hayward-Johnson to make the interception against Chase Lyman. Keith Hayward-Johnson didn't bite on the play action fake and picks it off on another fine play by the senior corner. Showing blitz, they don't come. Smith throws on the crossing route. TJ the catch. First down and more. Midfield, 45, needs a block. He's at the 40, down the right sideline of the 20, and finally run out of bounds by Jameel Powell at the 8-yard line of California. First and goal to go. Beavers coming up. Play action fake. Rush coming. Setha there. Kyle Rozelle there. And so is Ryan Atkinson, and it's a sack back to the 18-yard line. Smith over the middle for Prescott, makes the catch, breaks a tackle at the 45. He's in midfield at the 40, at the 35, to the 30, down the left sideline to the 20, to the 15, and thrown out of bounds at about the 8-yard line. Now they're going to mark it at the 15. No penalty flags down. Prescott with a great catch. Takes the snap under pressure. Jonathan breaks away from a would-be sack and runs for a first down. Still on his feet inside the Cal 30, down to the 27-yard line. Jonathan Smith, with the pocket collapsing, tucked it up and rumbles his way for a first down and one of the biggest runs he's made of his career. They run the counter to McCall, trying to run left, gets outside of the 20, to the 15, to the 10, and McCall down the left sideline is in. Touchdown, Beavers! Patrick McCall! Bowler under center. Play action fake. Has time over the middle. Intercepted by Jake Cookus at the 30. Cookus on the run to the 40. Laterals it to Darnell Robinson. And Darnell thrown out of bounds at the Cal 47-yard line. Cookus with the pick and the lateral.
Smelling potential roses in a civil war to come and preparing to debut in the nation's top 10. The Beavers trampled through Tucson and won for the first time at Arizona. Ladarius Jackson led the harassment of Ortiz Jenkins with 3 sacks, and OSU held the Wildcats to 69 yards rushing and 158 overall. Arizona stiffened in the red zone, but Ryan Seska converted all 4 field goal opportunities as the Beavers ran up 30-plus points for the 8th consecutive Saturday. Game 10.
Ortiz Jenkins in this 3-3 tie, a toss sweep to Leo Mills running right. James Allen defeats the block and throws Leo Mills out of bounds for a loss. Excellent pursuit by James Allen. And while on the 16-yard line of Arizona in this 3-3 tie, 6.5 to go in the first quarter on a chilly night in the desert in Tucson. Second and long, takes the snap, backpedals under pressure, runs away from it, still under the gun. Now he's flushed out to the right side, and James Allen is there to throw him down again. Smith goes out of the gun, bad snap. Jonathan somehow gathers it in, pumps, throws towards the end zone, caught! Touchdown, Beavers! Second and 11 for the Beavers. jumping his body to go high in the air and make the catch. And as the fans watch it on replay here at Arizona Stadium, again, they cheer the enemy's effort. On second and 10, out of the shotgun, the fourth sack of the night. Sefa O'Reilly coming off the edge on the right side, getting some time at defensive end. 23-9 Beavers, second down and four from the 21 of Arizona. They run the delay to Simon, and Kent breaks a tackle and breaks free. Simon and on his way, and he's in. Touchdown, Beavers. Off the left side, and I believe it was the old 35 counter again for 21 yards and a touchdown for Ken Simonton.
Keone Fraser, the defensive tackle, got kicked out to the outside that time. It was Jared Cornell coming out with a good block on the safety coming up, and then Mitch White seals Briggs, knocks him, pancakes him, and Ken Simonton takes it in the end zone.
Third down and 16. Ortiz Jenkins backpedals, has time, and it's intercepted by Richard Siegler. Siegler with a pick, tripped up at the Arizona 40, and down he goes at about the 39-yard line.
This war, the most meaningful in its 104-year history, was little more than a first-quarter battle. A pair of Smith-scoring strikes to Prescott gave the Beavs an early jump on their southern rivals, and the defense cooked any thought of retaliation with five interceptions and a blindside sack of Joey Harrington. A national ABC audience saw firsthand what would grace the cover of Sports Illustrated at week's end. The Oregon State Beavers, Pac-10 Conference co-champions. Game 11.
Captain Harrington off of play action to throw. DeLawrence Grant pulls him down for a sack. Back at the 20-yard line. D. Grant with a quick rush to sack Harrington for the first sack of the game. A loss of 9 on the play. Third and 32 coming up. Beavers show a blitz and they're coming as Harrington back to throw. Joey has time and throws over the middle, and it's incomplete and intercepted by Jake Kukas. Kukas at the 35-yard line, reverses his field, breaks a tackle, still on his feet inside the 30 to the 25. Tackle from behind inside the Oregon 20 at the 18-yard line. He's a slot to the right. Smith on a shotgun, throws on the post. Caught, and on his way in is Robert Prescott. Touchdown, Beavers on the slant. Play action fake to Simon. And Smith sets up post corner route. Prescott makes the catch at the 20, to the 10, to the 5. Touchdown, Beavers! On second and long, Harrington to throw. Joey has time. Throws, and it's batted up. Picked off again by Jake Kukas at the Oregon State 46-yard line. Jake Kukas with his second interception of the day.
It's fortunate to be, you know, in the right spot at the right time along time, so... You know, it was probably the luckiest day of my life, and you know, I still can't believe going back. I got three picks in the Civil War game.
Throw 27, play action fake by Smith, looking for another big play. He wobbles it out, intended for Chad Johnson, who dives and makes an incredible catch at the Oregon 29-yard line. What a play by number 80, Chad Johnson, diving headlong to make the catch. Simonton runs right, Kent pops it to the outside of the 20, 25, first down more, 30, 35-yard line out to the 40. And the Beavers, who have been struggling This will be the final snap of the game, and it'll be in the books. Jonathan takes it, and it's over. The Beavers 23, Oregon 13. In the Civil War, the Beavers have won it, and they're 10-1. And the celebration scene has begun again here at Reser Stadium.
Oregon State was represented in national and Pac-10 honors like never before. Simonton, Gibson, and Grant earned All-American selections. They were joined in the conference's first team by Ryan Seska and Dennis Weathersby. The second team included Darnell Robinson, Mitch White, T.J. Hushmanzada, and Terrence Carroll. And six others received honorable mention. Dennis Erickson did the nation's best coaching job in the eyes of the sporting news and earned his sixth Conference Coach of the Year honor, two each in the Big Sky, Big East, and now the Pac-10. The Beavers had run the table since October 7th, and the Northwest had run roughshod over the Pac-10. The Conference of Champions warranted a pair of entrants into the Elite Eight that play at the four bowl championship series sites. Do the math. Number 5, Oregon State, deserved to be in that mix. The yellow sport-coated Fiesta folks were equally astute.
So let's move along now and let you know who's going to be in the Tostitos Fiesta Bowl and the Nokia Sugar Bowl, and this is where Miami is going to come in. But first, look at this. It's going to be Oregon State, who had a huge argument to be in this game against the Fighting Irish of Notre Dame, who make a return to a big bowl. And that one promised to be a terrific one.
Was a key watching the players react. It was just a huge time in their lives to come from 3-8 to 5-6 to all of a sudden to 7-5. And now look at their expressions when all of a sudden they were going to play in a BCS bowl. It was an unbelievable feeling for me.
Plenty to prove. They did it with the backing of an ocean of orange. It congregated for the ultimate in pep rallies on New Year's Eve. Beavers. tradition would not take the field in Sun Devil Stadium.
Sometime when the team is up against it, and the brakes are beating the boys, tell them to go out there with all they got and win just one for the Gipper.
But what are we waiting for?
We are the best kept secret in the universe. Our mission is to monitor extraterrestrial activity on Earth. We are your best, last, and only line of defense. We work in secret. We exist in shadow.
And we dress in black.
Forget the next day. Numbering in the 30 to 40,000 range, they made for the closest thing to a home game atmosphere. The rest of the New Year's night was celebrated like a perpetual stroke of midnight. Game 12, Fiesta.
Vecchio comes under center, a huge third down play of the first series. They're on option and pitch it to Fisher. He needs to get to the 30, but he's knocked down at the 29-yard line by James Allen, a yard short of the first down. It'll be fourth down and about a half yard to go for the first down for the Fighting Irish, as the Beavers have held on the first three plays, James Allen stopping the option play short of the first down. A 33-yard field goal attempt for Ryan Seska, who was 14 for 17 on the year. Seska's kick is on the way and good, and the Beavers score first in the Tostitos Fiesta Bowl here in Tempe, Arizona, with the Beavers leading 3-0. They run the delay, and Jones is hammered, loses the football in the backfield. James Allen, though, with the tackle. Jones fell on his own football. A loss of 8 on the play, and Notre Dame will have to punt. What a play by the kid from Jefferson. Out of shotgun, play action to Simonton over the middle. Marty Maurer with the catch at the 40, and ahead to the Notre Dame 30-yard line. Marty Maurer with a pickup of 21. On the quickie from Jonathan Smith to Marty Maurer. Chad Johnson split left, second down and four for the Beavers. Play action, boot underneath to Maurer. Marty makes the catch, first down at the 40, to the 45 at the right sideline, cuts it back in the middle of the field to the Notre Dame 40, and dragged down from behind at the Irish 37-yard line. There's Jonathan to throw out of the shotgun, throws for Marty Maurer. He makes the catch at the 10. Did he shove off? The Notre Dame DB is asking for it as Marty Maurer makes the catch and goes down at the Irish 5-yard line. Second down and two out of the eye, and on the draw, it's Jones hit in the backfield and tackled at the 45-yard line. DeLawrence Grant, Jonathan from the right hash from his own 25, goes back to throw and throws the out, and it's caught, and it's going to be a big play. Chad Johnson down the left sideline. Nobody will catch Chad, and it's a touchdown, 75 yards for the Beavers. Well, we said it had better be a big play. They don't get much bigger than that, Bob.
No, it really doesn't. It was Clipper Jefferson, tried to come underneath and make the pick, but he was a half a step late. He couldn't get there.
Clear second and 21 from its 12. Pressure coming again on LaVecchio. He tries to step away from it, and he's sacked inside the 5-yard line by Ladarius Jackson. They'll mark the ball at the 4. LaVecchio back to throw. Pressured, steps away from a would-be sack. Now flushed out of the pocket. Rolling left to Lawrence Grant. Chases him down and sacks him back at the 27. Very tightly along the near of the sideline by Shane Walton. The Beavers run the counter to the left. A crease for Simon, and Simon into the 30 and out to the 34-yard line. First down on a gain of 14. Back to throw off a play action, and the ball comes out. Penalty fly goes down. The Beavers have recovered it at the Irish 25-yard line.
Regard the penalty. There's a fumble in the play. First down, LSU.
Jonathan Smith sends Chad Johnson in motion from under center. Back to throw goes Jonathan. Looking on the out on the far side. Caught by T.J. Hushmanzada.
DJ, run out of bounds at the one or no signal yet, and now penalty flags go up. Michael, go ahead.
I am right down here in the end zone, Mike. TJ definitely got that ball across the goal line before going out of bounds. He thought it was a touchdown. He was celebrating. He got a penalty.
Celebration foul against the scoring team. The touchdown count, the penalty will be penalized on the try.
And they'll run option to the right side for the second time tonight. Jones gets the pitch. The Beavers stringing it out. Ziegler misses a tackle. But Duane Edwards, or Eric Manning, pardon me, and Darnell Robinson do not. They've not been behind. They run option to the left. And a bad pitch being chased by Ziegler. Julius Jones, and Jones is able to fall on it. Back at the 25-yard line. Joey Hildbold, a returnable kick. DJ takes it to the 27. He's at the 40. Runs into his own man at the 45. Gets out to midfield. Breaks away. Still no whistle. But there was a fumble. And on his way to the house, I believe, is Terrell Roberts. Recovering a fumble and taking it into the end zone. TJ Hushmanzada fumbling the ball, and Terrell Roberts picking it up and takes it in. Javen Hunter, the other receiver, as LaVecchio throws, and it's intercepted by Darnell Robinson at the 23-yard line of Notre Dame. Darnell makes the catch. Immediately his knee hit the ground. Out of shotgun. The slant caught. Touchdown, Beavers! Chad Johnson with the TD. Right hash, it's a play action fake. Jonathan to throw, throwing on the post corner. Robert Prescott goes up and makes a great catch at the Irish 25. Robert Prescott, the down and out, makes a brilliant catch for 25 yards to the Irish 25. And they run the inside handoff. Simon, it has a crease. He's at the 10 and 10 inside the 5-yard line to the 4. It's first and goal from the right hash at the Irish 4. Simon and up the gut, and Ken Simon and into the end zone. Touchdown, Beavers. How fitting and appropriate that the greatest back in the history of Oregon State University, Ken Simonton, who has, with his heart and soul and leadership, helped lead the Beavers here, scores a touchdown in this grandest stage of all.
The starters in black didn't see the fourth quarter, leading 41-3 with 20 minutes remaining. Offensive MVP Jonathan Smith completed 16 of 24 for 305 yards and three scores.
Well, it was definitely exciting. You know, it was fun to be up there with Darnell and Coach Erickson and his wife. To look up at the fans, to look at on the ground all my teammates, there was a genuine sense of accomplishment. You always want to play great in the big games, and so it was a fun deal for the whole team to have such a strong and solid win.
Defensive MVP Darnell Robinson was the catalyst for two scores with his blitz and the ensuing fumble, followed soon after by his timely interception. It was the greatest of days. Associated Press, fifth in the ESPN USA Today poll. They amassed the school's first 10-win season with the Civil War and rolled to an 11th win over the fightless Irish.
I think it'd be a stretch to say surprise. I think you go in and that's some of your goals. You want to have a great season. You want to win the Pac-10 championship. You want to win your bowl game. You want to go to a big bowl game. That was kind of our expectations.
Yeah, we're kind of surprised we lost that game.
They did it with family. The belief in their system made the short in stature stand tall. The savvy of an undersized quarterback, the pride instilled by an even smaller Heisman candidate. They teamed to lead a potent, deadly, and balanced family that scored a school record 400 points in a dozen starts.
These last 2 years has been a situation where it's about winning, and we knew we had to just work together to the fullest.
That you're all together as one, that you believe in each other, and that you fight through adversity and things together as a team. And when you have that kind of a team or